about the Christmas something, how Jesus was born and where he was born. Many times we have a wrong mentality that Jesus was born in a place where there's cows and sheep and goats and many things. We all have this information that Jesus was born in certain place. But I'm going to show you where was exactly Jesus born and why was he placed in that place. No, I'll show you a picture. See, the real manger, it used to look something like this. I think everybody can see this real manger. This real manger was something looking like this. This was the original place how the manger was looking. No, so I want to tell you from this thing. You know, how was this manger made? This manger is not made of woods or something where grass is laid or something. I will tell you why was this manger. No, and if you see this manger, and if you see this tomb on the other side, it looks exactly the same. This is the tomb where Jesus was laid when he was died. And this is a manger where Jesus was laid when he was born. There are two things we have to know from this thing. One is a manger and one is an empty tomb. If it looks both look the same, it looks the same. At least it's like a triangle box. Even if you see a tomb, it looks like a triangle box. But I want to tell you something about this manger. How was this manger to be there? I'll tell you something about this manger. You know, there's something called as the Tower of the Flock. You know, it is said, the angels came and told for shepherds, you'll find a baby wrapped in a swaddling clothes. You know, the moment the angels told the shepherds, you know, the first good news went to a shepherd. It didn't went to a pastor or a preacher or a big leader. It went to a small type of people who were shepherds. First good news went to them. And you know, when the good news, angels, I'll show you a sign. You see a small child or a baby wrapped in a swaddling clothes. You know, the moment the shepherds came to know, the angels told them about something, and they'll find a baby. Then they exactly visit that place. They knew which is that place where the baby will be found. No, because they knew the prophecy that Jesus was going to be born in Bethlehem. But they knew one place where the angels prophesied that he is going to be in a manger. And they knew exactly where is the manger. The manger was something at a place called Migdal Eder. This is a place in Bethlehem. It's called Migdal Eder. If you see the name, it says Tower of the Flock. Means where there are shepherds or where there are sheep over there, it's called as a Tower of the Flock. Where there are Tower of the Flock means sheep and all his animals are there. And so in Hebrew it is called as Migdal Eder. So I'll tell you something about this Migdal Eder. No, I'll tell you something about this Migdal Eder right now. You know, this place was a place where Jesus was actually born. You know, what the shepherds used to do actually every year. You know, they used to put the sheep in a manger. Every sheep which has to be taken as a sacrifice in the temple, they used to put the first sheep, any sheep, into the manger. And they used to, all the shepherds used to inspect that sheep. If the sheep had even one of a cut, so they used to not take them as sheep which is to be sacrificed. So they used to choose and they used to see a perfect sheep and they used to put them in that manger. Every perfect sheep has to be going in that manger. And you know, just because this sheep is a perfect sheep, they used to cover the sheep in a swaddling clothes actually. They used to cover that sheep in a swaddling clothes. So the moment the angel told this shepherd that you see a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, they came to exactly which is that place. Because they know there is only one place where they always put somebody in a swaddling clothes. And they knew that it's the same place where they always put the sheep in a swaddling clothes. The perfect sheep. The perfect lamb, I will say. Even Jesus was a perfect lamb. And Jesus was put in the same place. And you know, these sheep have been raised and taken care of and they were washed very carefully. Because they are not even one of the spot when they grow up. Because they are very perfect. Because every perfect sacrifice has to come in the temple. Simply, even Jesus was a perfect sacrifice. Jesus was a perfect sacrifice, actually. Jesus was a perfect guy, the perfect lamb of the God who takes all the sins of the world. That's why Jesus was put in there in the same place where they were wrapped in swaddling clothes. Because it was initially a place where sheep used to be wrapped in swaddling clothes and they used to be kept in a manger. But at the same place, the shepherds came to know immediately. The shepherds went and found a baby Jesus. Otherwise, it would have been very tough for shepherds to be found. And these were not the ordinary shepherds. These were shepherds who actually, who were meant for such sacrifices. But every sheep or every lamb is going to be sacrificed. were born from these places. So even Jesus was born in the same place, the same place, because it is a Bible prophecy. It says that it is the Lamb of God who is going to take away the sins of the world. Now actually, I think you all need to know the idea where, why was Jesus put in that the small manger. It became the first tabernacle upon his earth. This is God dwelt among men. First time in this entire history of